Greetings. I was watching a video from channel DCCI. They are witnessing at Speaker's Corner in London. A Muslim woman walks up, attempting to make a winning point of logic.
Who does Allah pray to?
Yeah. As you say, Jesus is the Son of God and He is God. You have the Trinity. So are you trying to say that Mary gave birth to God?
Christians think Jesus is both Son of God and God, right? Then did Mary give birth to God? Drop the mic. She's thinking that means Mary created God. This Muslim woman thinks her trick argument is an unanswerable winner. However, the problem with parrots is that you cannot destroy a stupid point with a Socratic method in a soundbite bumper sticker length response. I'll strive to keep this under 10 minutes. What is God? God is a spirit. In John 4:24 we read, God is spirit, and his worshipers must worship him in spirit and in truth. This is Prophet Jesus talking, the Son of God, who was also God. God is a spirit, an eternal spirit with no beginning and no end. Is Jesus God? Yes. John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God, speaking of the Word. And in John 17:5, Jesus prayed, Now, Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. Before creation. So Jesus was with God before the beginning, before creation. What is a human? A human is a Trinity. We are comprised of an outer man you can see and an inner or hidden man you cannot see. But wait, that's only two things, Texas. Psalm 51:6, Behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part you will make me to know wisdom. 1 Peter 3:4, But let it be the hidden man of the heart, in that which is not corruptible, even the ornament of a meek and quiet spirit, which is in the sight of God of great price. So we have the outer man, which is your body, and we have the inner, hidden man, which is you, your spirit. And they are connected by your soul. Those are the two parts of the inward or hidden man, your spirit, which is you, and your soul. Regarding the soul and spirit, the Word of God even defines these. Hebrews 4:12, For the Word of God is living and powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit, and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. In parallel describes the two. Your soul is the joints and thoughts. It is what joins your spirit to your body. This is where your thoughts, your mind, your consciousness reside. Your spirit is the marrow, is the intentions. If you think of bone marrow, think of bone marrow, the inner part of the bone, which is where your blood cells are created. The marrow is what gives you life. The spirit, likewise, is where your intentions, your motivations, your unction, your very life comes from. So you are a spirit, your spirit is created and has no ending. While you live in this space-time, you occupy a body. Your spirit is joined to or knit to your body by your soul. Psalm 139:13, For you created my innermost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. Your spirit is created. For you created my innermost being, and God knit your spirit to your body. You knit me together in my mother's womb. So just to be clear, a human is a spirit. A human living in space-time is a spirit knit together with a body. What about God? How could God enter his creation, aka space-time? Hebrews 10:5 tells us, consequently, when Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifices and offerings you have not desired, but a body have you prepared for me. Jesus, who is God, who is a spirit, needed a body. God prepared a body for him. In John 1:14, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. In Philippians 2:5, let this mind be in you which was also in Christ Jesus, who, existing in the form of God, what form does God exist in? Spirit. What form did Jesus exist in? Spirit. Who, existing in the form of God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped. Jesus was equal with God, but did not consider clutching or hanging on to that. Who, existing in the form of God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but emptied himself. But emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being made in human likeness. Jesus accepted the body that was prepared for him, and being found in the appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. We see the outer man. Jesus appeared on the outside to be nothing but a man. God entered his creation by allowing his spirit to be knit into a human body, a body which grew in the womb of Mary, a virgin. Then did Mary give birth to God? In the mind of this Muslim, and every Muslim who thinks this way, they are really asking, did Mary create God? And that is the pathetic, tragic ignorance Islam installs in them. But if a Christian is asked, and given time to fully answer, did Mary give birth to God? We can easily say, yes. Mary's womb was the factory that God used to prepare a body for his word, for his spirit, to knit with and become flesh. Yes, Mary carried the body, prepared the body, as prophet David foretold. And to be clear, no, Mary did not create God. And Christianity does not teach that Mary created God. Christians think Jesus is both Son of God and God, right? Then did Mary give birth to God? You think Mary created God? Satan's stupid ignorance to confuse and condemn Mohammedans to the flames. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.